Now I'm gonna build the experimental setup according to the circuit diagram as shown here. But since we use two-way switch in this experiment to alter the circuit as charging and discharging of the capacitor, I should remind you the nodes of the switch. These are A, B, and S nodes of the switch respectively. Here, when I push this button, fourth, A and S nodes will be connected to each other. So when we look at the circuit here, A node and S node is here. So when they are connected to each other, the circuit will be charging of the capacitor case. If I pull this button back, B and S node will be connected to each other. So here. So the circuit will be NRC circuit. So the stored charge on the capacitor will be dissipated through this resistor. So this situation will be referred to the discharging of the capacitor. Now let's build the circuit. When we look at the circuit diagram, we see that capacitor and resistor are connected in serial. Since we use this capacitor in the circuit, we should take the polarity into account while plugging it to the circuit. So I put the positive terminal of the capacitor at left, like that. According to this direction, I will insert other circuit elements. Now I insert the resistor here. Let's put this here and resistor here. To make the connection between them, I use a banana type connector cable. Here, the capacitance of this capacitor is 2.2 millifarad, and this resistor has a resistance of 10 kilo ohms. So this part is built. I mean, R and C is connected each other. Now let me insert the other circuit elements. Here the positive terminal of the voltage source is connected to the anode of the switch. So I plug the one end of the connector cable to the anode and the other one to the positive terminal of the voltage source. Here the positive terminal of the voltage source, and this black socket is the negative terminal of the voltage source. Let me insert the cable. A, node, and positive terminal of the source. Yes, this is the S node, and it is connected to the positive terminal of the capacitor here. So let me insert another cable between them. Now we completed this part. So there left these branches. And when we look at the circuit diagram, we see that negative terminal of the voltage source is connected to the B node and emitter together. So B node and the negative terminal of the voltage source is the same point. So I plug this cable here and here. Pay attention, this is the negative terminal and this is the positive terminal of the power supply. Now, due to the emitter is in the between resistor and B node, I plug the positive probe of the emitter here and the negative one to the B node. Here. And to measure potential difference across the capacitor, I put another multimeter here to observe the voltage on the capacitor. Yes. Okay. Now the circuit is completed. Let's pass to the measurements. Before starting the measurement, notice that we apply 10 volt to the circuit and I operate the power supply. And we should make short circuit on the capacitor in order to make it to be fully discharged. Like that. And you see that voltmeter shows 0 volt and ammeter shows again 0 milliampere approximately. So it is negligible, this part. And we will also use a chronometer or stopwatch to record the current and voltage values with respect to the time given in the table. So I will insert a stopwatch here. We will start this stopwatch and change the switch for charging case simultaneously. So now I should use my two hands at the same time while doing it. Let's start it. At the same time, I will start the stopwatch and push this button to the fourth. As you see in the multimeters, voltage values are increasing, which shows us the charging of the capacitor. And the current flowing in the circuit provided by voltage source is decreasing, which also shows us the charging of the capacitor. When we see the current is zero, it means that the capacitor is fully charged. Now we are waiting for the potential difference across the capacitor is approximately 10 volt. For discharging, I mean, you can do like that. I will pull this button back or down and start the chronometer again, and we will see the differences on the voltage and current values. Now you see the voltage is decreasing at the end of discharging. It will show us 0 volt. Yes, for this video it will be too much time for us to wait, also for you. So we will not wait too much, and I will stop here the experiment, and we will record these numbers also for discharging, illustration of discharging for you, and we will send also the numbers or the values for current and voltage values.